Hello everyone, this is Chromý and together we will continue the course Interdisciplinary Approaches to Language and its Use. In this presentation, we will focus on the critical period in second language acquisition hypothesis. We already discussed the critical period in the first language acquisition hypothesis in one of the previous presentations. The evidence so far suggests that there is indeed a critical period for acquiring grammar of the first language. However, we may also ask whether there is something similar for the second language. There are many cases of speakers who started to learn a second language later than the first, but who ultimately attained a native speaker level of proficiency in that language. Also, many people who tried to learn a foreign language in the adulthood may tell you that it is much more complicated for them than when they learned a foreign language in the high school, for example. In other words, it seems to be the case that the older we are, the harder it is for us to learn another language. Of course, various factors must be in play because there are huge individual differences. Also, one must differentiate between different linguistic levels. There are speakers who acquired a language almost on a native level in the adult life, if we consider grammar and lexicon, but who are not able to acquire native-like pronunciation in that language. But the main question is whether we can identify any period in life after which we just cannot learn another language fully. One study which tries to answer this question is a paper by Kenji Hakuta, Ellen Bialystok and Edward Wiley, Critical Evidence, a Test of the Critical Period Hypothesis for Second Language Acquisition. The authors analyzed data from United States Census from the year 1990. They focused on Spanish and Chinese immigrants. In the census, respondents had to self-assess their English ability on a 5-point scale. Also, they stated their level of education, their age, and the year when they came to the USA, from which it was able to calculate the age when they arrived to the USA. The self-assessed English ability was then related to demographic characteristics of the speakers. Here we can see two plots which relate proficiency in English with age of immigration for the native speakers of Spanish and native speakers of Chinese. Different lines are used for different education levels. There are no abrupt breaks in the curves. We can see that the proficiency in English is steadily decreasing as a function of age of immigration. Also, more educated people tend to be generally more proficient, at least based on the self-reports. In sum, one can say that age when we start to learn a foreign language influences our ability to learn a second language, but from these results, it seems that there is no abrupt change in the trajectory which would support the idea of the critical period. However, a different finding has been recently presented by Joshua Hartshorne, Joshua Tenenbaum and Steven Pinker. They conducted a mega-study using an online grammar quiz, which was widely shared on social media. The quiz combined several tasks, such as picture selection, gap-filling or grammatical judgments. Altogether, the authors collected valid data from 670,000 participants. And it was quite a diverse sample because 38 languages were represented by at least 1,000 native speakers. Almost 250,000 speakers were English monolinguals. About 45,000 speakers were immersion learners of English who were either simultaneous bilinguals or later learners who spent at least 90% of their life since the age of first exposure to English in an English-speaking country. Almost 270,000 speakers were non-immersion learners of English who spent at most 10% of post-exposure life in an English-speaking country and no more than 1 year in total. There was also an immediate group, but this group was not analyzed for methodological reasons. The authors performed a computational model of the data, and the results supported the existence of a sharp critical period for second language acquisition. The authors claim that the second language learning ability is preserved to almost 18 years of life, and then it declines steadily. Before we will conclude this presentation, I have one reading tip for you. If you are interested in the age effects in second language acquisition, you should read a paper by David Birdsong, Plasticity, Variability and Age in Second Language Acquisition and Bilingualism. It is an interesting and recent review of various studies on the topic. Importantly, Birdsong argues that age is not the only important factor for second language acquisition. Also, the degree of L1 activation, first language attrition, and relative dominance of the languages modulate attainment levels across second language learners. If you enjoy the presentations, we would be glad if you would like them on YouTube. That is all from me now. See you next time.